Hello, everybody. Welcome to a brand new episode of That New Toy Smell. I'm your host, Mitch Live, and I collect action figures. And today, we are having a look at Death Metal Batman by McFarlane Toys. Here we have Death Metal Batman from the DC Multiverse toy line by McFarlane Toys. He comes in the very typical DC Multiverse packaging, which features the full frontal clear plastic view. You got clear plastic on the top and some clear plastic on the side, just illuminating the figure beautifully inside the box. The box stands 11 inches, if you're including the little flap at the back, just about 10 inches if you're not. The side of the package features the Dark Knight Death Metal logo. It says Batman, Dark Knights, Death Metal, and McFarlane Toys across the bottom. On the back of the package, it features artwork that will come with the little collectible card that comes with the figure, and it'll also tell you the source material that this is from. On the side here, it says Dark Knight Death Metal Comics number 1. And at the bottom here, it shows you some other figures that are available in this line. From right to left, we've got Batman from the Arkham Knight, we've got Deathstroke, we've got Superman, we've got Robin, and another Batman, this time just Todd McFarlane Batman. They make a lot of Batmans. Alright, let's crack in. Let's crack her open. Okay, here we have Batman out of his box, and first test, will he stand up by himself without the stand? Yes, just barely. Oh lord, does he ever feel tipsy, and I believe this scythe might be helping him stand currently, but here he is, along with everything he comes with, which includes his stat card and a DC-branded black. Can you see the DC? There you go. The DC-branded black figure stand. He has 22 points of articulation. That's ultra articulation. Now with ultra articulation. Ultra articulation. Yeah, as soon as you touch him, he doesn't want to stand again. But maybe we'll just put him on a stand. The DC Multiverse toy line is a 7-inch toy line, and this particular figure stands 6.5 inches tall. This is, of course, from a more recent, very dark, gritty-looking Batman comic series. The artwork featured on the card is from the very first issue of this comic, and he is seen carrying his scythe and riding his Batcycle. And we will be reviewing the Batcycle in our next episode of That New Toy Smell. So again, make sure to subscribe and check back for that juicy episode. And his bike and his scythe both seem to be iconic features of this Batman. Let's see if we can get him to sort of do a double hand hold here. Now this hand is actually a lot more closed than the other one. He does not want to do a double hand hold. You can see how open this hand is naturally versus how closed looking this hand is on its own. I'm assuming at the very least that this hand will fit nicely on the handlebars of the Batcycle when we open that and take a sniff. You know, I gotta say, his ankle has one of those ball joints where his foot can go, I don't know, 360 degrees all around, and then he's got the extra toe articulation so his toe can bend all the way up. And look, are people really asking for this much articulation in their ankle joints? Do they need the foot to be able to point every single way? There's only one thing I care about, and that is when the figure has good ankles and he stands. He stands! I mean, he stands fine, absolutely fine with his stand, so I shouldn't complain. In terms of detail, he does look really cool. He looks badass. That's the basic summation of what he looks like, and the vibe this character gives off is badass. He's a mix of soft rubber and hard plastic. Speaking of that new toy smell, this particular figure is very pungent with that new toy, that plastic smell. So, you know, crack a window when you're opening this box. Overall, I'd say he's a great character, one of the cooler looking Batmans from the DC Multiverse line. And just the detail in all the little chains and metal skulls on him, and his blades, his arm guards, his thing of things, whatever you call him, he is a great looking figure. And that brings us to the end of another episode of That New Toy Smell. As always, there will be links in the description that you can follow to purchase your own Death Metal Batman by McFarlane Toys. He is a great looking figure. Can't wait to see what he looks like on his bat cycle. So make sure to tune in next week. Thank you for hanging out with us on the Toy Shelf. And remember, you're never too old to play with toys.